Hi there and welcome to this video on this GPU, the RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Server Edition. So the RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell is our universal GPU that caters for both AI and graphics workloads. It has 96 gigabytes of GPU memory, a third more compute cores than its predecessor, the L40S, and in most cases it's anything between 2 to 5 times faster than the L40S, depending on the workload. But this video isn't about speeds and feeds. It concentrates on something that makes this GPU pretty unique. MIG, or multi-instance GPU, has been around for a few years now, but limited to the compute-only GPUs like the A100, the H100, H200, etc. With RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell, we now have MIG for graphics workloads too. So what is MIG and how does it differ from vGPU? So this is not really about MIG versus vGPU, but more like MIG technology versus time slicing technology. In both cases, vGPU software is the enabler to set up and manage the GPU sharing. So in terms of time slicing, each virtual machine has its own GPU memory allocated, but access to the GPU cores, encoders, decoders, etc., is done on a time sharing basis. So effectively, you get all of the GPU power for some of the time. This works really well for workloads such as graphics, where GPU demand tends to be quite spiky. With MIG, on the other hand, the division is done spatially, where you get a smaller segment of the overall GPU dedicated to your workload, or in this case, your VM. So you get some of the GPU, but for all of the time. This lends itself very much more to sustained workloads such as AI training and inference and high performance computing. So does MIG replace vGPU for sharing a GPU between different VMs? So traditionally, GPU sharing for graphics workloads used time slicing. Now that we have MIG for graphics workloads too, does this mean we don't need vGPU at all? No, because time slicing and MIG are complementary technologies and are simply different ways to share a GPU, each best suited to different types of workload. In either case, vGPU is the control plane. So think of the options as MIG-based vGPU versus time-sliced vGPU. So do I need a vGPU license to run MIG? On a hypervisor, yes. If you have virtualization, then vGPU software is the way that you manage your GPU sharing. MIG partitions are created and assigned to VMs using the vGPU manager software that's included with a standalone vGPU product or with the NVIDIA AI Enterprise product if you're running AI workloads. We're going to be delivering this functionality on both vSphere and supported KVM platforms in the first release. One of the cool things about the vSphere implementation specifically is that you can use vCenter to create and delete these MIG partitions on the fly without having to use the command line tools. Let me show you. So here you can see we have the vSphere console open and we're logged into the console. If we type NVIDIA SMI in the console, you'll see here we have MIG enabled, but we actually don't have any MIG partitions configured yet. So in order to do that, it's very, very simple. We go to the virtual machines themselves. And as you can see here, I've got a MIG slice already configured, a 20C profile within here. If I just go to another VM, MIG2 for instance, I can choose a completely different MIG profile. It is actually heterogeneous, so we can have MIG sizes within here, as you know. Also notice, of course, we're running an A100 here, but the principle is the same for the RTX PRO 6000. So now after we've started our virtual machines, what you'll see is that now VMware has dynamically created those MIG partitions on the GPU for us without us having to do anything at the command line. If I go to a third VM, I can add another MIG partition here, turn on that virtual machine. As you can see within here, you have the list of VMs that are running on this GPU at the moment, all running MIG technology. Again, if we just run NVIDIA SMI again, you'll see it's created that partition on the GPU dynamically on the fly so that we can run completely isolated workloads. Now, if we just go ahead and turn these virtual machines off, what you'll see is that VMware is very good and it clears up after itself as well. So as you can see now, if we run NVIDIA SMI, those MIG partitions are now gone and the GPU is ready for other virtual machines to use. This gives you the ease of management benefits for virtualization and extends this to management of MIG slices too. So can you use MIG on RTX PRO 6000 without vGPU software? So yes, in some cases, if you're running a bare metal Linux environment running something like Kubernetes and a containerized environment, i.e. no hypervisor, then you don't need vGPU. Essentially, the deal is, if you are using a hypervisor, you need virtual GPU software to manage your virtual machines and allocate your GPU slices, whether they're MIG slices or time sliced. Probably the only exception to this is if you have a hypervisor, but you're passing the whole GPU through to a single VM, and you want to run different MIG partitions within that single VM. But this wouldn't really be a common use case. Which GPUs support MIG with vGPU? So at the moment, the RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Server Edition is the only MIG-capable GPU to be supported with vGPU. Both of the workstation editions of the RTX PRO Blackwell support MIG as well, but at this time they're not going to be supported by vGPU, as vGPU is primarily a server and a data center solution. So what configurations of MIG are supported on the RTX PRO 6000? On the RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell, you can configure up to 4 MIG partitions. You can slice up the GPU into quarters, or halves, or a combination of both. What's also amazing is that you can run up to 12 time-sliced vGPU-enabled VMs within each MIG partition. So you can have, for instance, 4 MIG partitions, each with 24 gigabytes of GPU memory, and then create 12 times vGPU time slice profiles, each with 2 gigabytes within each MIG partition. You could also run a mixture of different workloads, each with their own demands, on a single GPU, giving you maximum flexibility. This would also be a great way to get high utilization and density out of your GPU without having to have high contention on the time slicing. So to use vGPU with MIG, what license do I need to buy? Okay, so nothing changes from before with respect to licensing. You just buy the right license for your workload. If you're using RTX PRO 6000 with MIG and vGPU for office work or VDI workloads, for instance, you would need our VPC license. If you're running the same for graphics professionals or for data scientists wanting an AI workstation, you would need RTX virtual workstation licenses. If you're using RTX PRO 6000 with a hypervisor for pure compute or for artificial intelligence workloads, the product you need is NVIDIA AI Enterprise. So when will we be able to do graphics with vGPU and MIG? So of course, we already have MIG with some GPUs, and time slicing has been around for over 10 years, but specifically to have spatial partitioning and time slicing available on both compute and graphics workloads, we're planning for a Q3 2025 release. We're supporting vSphere and KVM in the first release. Another thing to bear in mind is that we plan to support one VM per MIG slice at release time for both VMware and KVM, but to get time-sliced vGPUs within the same MIG partition on VMware, we'll have to wait until early 2026. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and good luck with your vGPU project.